Hi again. I'm Anthony, and I was... check out this notification I just got. It says that the AQI, or Air Quality Index, level is 125 today, and that I might want to stay inside. But why? I mean, I guess it does look kind of hazy outside today. Have you ever noticed a day like this, or seen an alert about a high AQI level? AQI is basically a way of measuring how clean or dirty the air outside is. But what do you think it is that causes the AQI level to change? I mean, how does air get dirty? And what happens when it does? Well, we're going to find out. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to identify common causes of air pollution and explain how air pollution impacts the Earth's atmosphere and surface. Let's get into it. So, how does the air itself get dirty? It's actually not that different from how your room gets dirty. You leave some stuff on the floor, maybe accidentally spill something, and before long, whoops, it's kind of a mess in here. It works the same way in the natural world, but instead of just calling it a mess, we call it pollution. Pollution is when harmful materials called pollutants are introduced into the natural environment. We'll be focusing on pollution found in the atmosphere, called air pollution. Unfortunately, there are lots of different sources of air pollution. Can you think of some of them? Pause the video here and record your thoughts in your guided notes. One of the main causes of air pollution is from industrial sources like factories and power plants. They burn fossil fuels like oil and coal, and that releases tons of pollutants into the air, like nitrogen dioxide gas and even a gaseous form of lead. Vehicles like cars, trains, and airplanes cause air pollution in a similar way. After all, we know that matter is never created or destroyed, so when a car burns a tank of gasoline for fuel, it must go somewhere, right? That fuel becomes a toxic gas called carbon monoxide that enters the atmosphere. Not all pollutants are gas, though. Another common pollutant is particulate matter, which is just tiny little pieces of solids or liquids that get swept up into the Earth's atmosphere. You can think of particulate matter as dust made of things like chemicals or plastics. They often come from construction sites and factories. Pollutants like nitrogen dioxide and particulate matter are all harmful to the environment and aren't really found in nature in any significant amounts. But some pollutants are a little different. For example, carbon dioxide is the gas that all animals breathe out and that plants take in for photosynthesis. It's naturally occurring and is important to the environment. But human activities like burning fuel create way more carbon dioxide than the air would have naturally, even though carbon dioxide is naturally occurring. It can still pollute the environment when there's too much of it. So burning gas, running factories, and generating power all create air pollution. Now, I know these might not seem like a problem on a small scale, but remember, there are billions of people on Earth, all contributing to air pollution in different ways. Over time, all that pollution really starts to add up. In fact, it can get so significant that it can even be harmful to breathe in, which is why we track the AQI. It's basically a measure of how much of different pollutants like carbon monoxide and particulate matter are floating around in the air that day. Areas with lots of people, cars, factories, and other things that cause air pollution tend to have a higher AQI level. But since our atmosphere is always circulating air around, this kind of pollution can impact anywhere on the planet. Now, we know what causes air pollution. But what effects do you think it might have? Well, air pollution has tons of harmful effects on the natural world, one of which is smog. This is a visible haze of air pollution. It isn't just kind of gross looking either, it's actually harmful for the health of people, plants, and animals. I mean, would you want to breathe that stuff in? No, thank you. Air pollution can also cause acid rain, which is when pollutants mix with water vapor in the atmosphere and later fall to the surface as rain. These pollutants can then mix into the water that plants and animals need. And since these pollutants are often pretty harsh chemicals, acid rain can also damage buildings by increasing the rate of weathering. But one of the biggest impacts of air pollution actually ties back to what we learned about heat transfer in the different layers of the atmosphere. Some pollutants, like carbon dioxide, are often called greenhouse gases. Greenhouse gases are gases that trap heat within the Earth's atmosphere. The Earth naturally has a thin layer of greenhouse gases that trap heat and keep the planet's temperature consistent. The thing is, a lot of air pollution is made up of greenhouse gases, which is making this layer get thicker and thicker. If this layer of greenhouse gases continues to get thicker, what do you think might happen? Pause the video here and record your predictions in your guided notes. Since the year 1880, the average temperature all over the world has gotten about 2 degrees warmer, and many scientists think that air pollution making the layer of greenhouse gases thicker might have something to do with why. Over time, this could become a bigger problem. So, what can we do about it? Well, here's the good news. There are tons of ways we can prevent air pollution. Many countries around the world are setting limits on burning fossil fuels, and where possible, shifting to the use of clean energy sources, like solar and wind power. Electric vehicles that don't need gas are also becoming more and more popular, which could really help to reduce air pollution over time. But there are also lots of things that you can do to help out now. One of the easiest ways is to use less energy, just through simple changes like turning off lights when you leave a room or unplugging electronics that you aren't using. You can also try to reduce, reuse, and recycle whenever possible. And you can even plant a garden to help grow air-purifying plants. You can also try to use public transportation, walk or bike to get places, and encourage your friends and family to do the same. When more people get around in these ways, there are fewer cars on the road, which means less air pollution. And just by understanding air pollution, you've already taken an important step towards preventing it. So let's recap what we've learned today. You now know that air pollution is caused by many things, including cars, planes, factories, and power plants. Air pollution can have harmful effects on the environment, including acid rain and smog. And there are many things that we can do to prevent air pollution, like reducing the energy we use and walking instead of driving. Be sure to check out the extension activities that go with this lesson to find out more about how we can prevent air pollution. And remember, in Earth science, as in life, you rock. I'll see you next time.